So we are happy to announce that Unknown Group is merging with Ventures One, and we will still call it Unknown Group. And I'm happy that we are now doing this together and going to the future.
I built several businesses myself, and about 10 years ago, I grouped all these ventures into Ventures One and started Ventures One with the intention of building a new venture capitalist. And that's what we have been doing for the last 10 years with offices in Singapore and Holland in The Hague. And we invest in start and scale-ups. And we don't focus on a specific sector, but we focus on excellent management teams, obviously with a good business case, but team to me is always number one.
You had around 20 investments up to now?
Yes.
And then you merged with us. Pourquoi?
We were looking to make our model more scalable. And with a small team of 10, 15 people at Ventures One, with a high professional level in specific areas, that is not making it possible to scale beyond Unknown. And I think with the combination with Unknown, we have the scalability ourselves to support companies better.
When I met Edward, it was for the first time I met someone who thinks alike and we can go very fast. I think we have the same background, spent a lot of time in The Hague, which is funny. And we both started off at a young age, being a student, selling antiques, starting to being an entrepreneur, try all kind of stuff, failing sometimes, succeeding sometimes. I started at the university in Rotterdam, doing a lot of activities as a student also to promote entrepreneurship, which was really not something that was normal. There was no startup scene then. People that studied with me went to a traineeship for a big bank, and they also found I was a bit strange to doing this kind of business plans, which is just still a business plan at that time. One of the initiatives we created in this period was Get in the Ring. It's a startup competition. Get in the ring from you have to go into the ring as a founder, beat the market, go worldwide. We created that in 2011, the concept 12, the first event, with the idea to see how we can have local startups more internationally exposed, and also how we can have a more engaging event. And the idea is that two startups go to in the ring, and mainly they battle in the ring to see who's the better startup and get the likability of the crowd. The nice thing is that we started that in Rotterdam, and in 3 years' time, it was in 110 countries around the world. And nowadays, we do around 200, 250 events in every place that you can imagine, from Congo to Riyadh to Brazil, etc. And we have a lot of talented young guys and girls that have propositions that I think are really cool, but they need the market development. Then corporate companies start to ask us, hey, can you find me the best startup for this solution? Or we want to be a player in this field. We want to know more about this technology, how it can be applicable for us, because we don't want to be Kodak or pushed out of the market. So we started to work with these corporates to find them the best collaborations. And that's basically what we are doing for the last 5 years. We have a lot of big brands around the world, from PepsiCo, from Emirates, really in all corners of the world we work with it. Juditha Birla in India, a big multinational there. And we really start to connect them and doing pilots and even testing their product with the corp.
I think the combination of Unknown and Ventures One Group is great. As you say, get in the ring, finding the right startups, not only in a specific sector or in a specific country, but basically worldwide in different sectors really fits with what we do. The connection with the corporates to create traction, to be able to establish a product market fit is excellent and is very valuable for founders and startups to be able to so quickly gain traction. And that combined with capital and this all together, we basically call the venture engine. Yeah. whereby we supply capital, knowledge, know-how, traction, and this combination will enable startups to grow faster and more professionally. Obviously, startups can do it themselves. That's not the issue. But I think they can do it better if they do it in combination with like-minded other startups, which are complementary to what they do. What we haven't touched upon is impact, sustainability, the SDGs of the United Nations. But we would like to support companies who have an impact-driven strategy. Not the greenwashing, but real creating impact with the service or product they're developing. And you see more and more in our portfolio of companies that we invest in companies who are driven by sustainability, by impact. We don't want to just create companies to exit and make a huge return. We want to create companies because they add value somewhere in their market. And I also think for corporates, it's a safe feeling that we don't focus on one startup in one country. And I always say, you know what you know, but you don't know what you don't know. And with Get in the Ring, we basically try to find startups worldwide in a certain sector. And both for corporates and startups who work together, they can be assured that we will find startups in every corner of the world who could add value to each other and thus have a better overview on where the whole market is going and what is available within this market.
That's maybe also a personal driver that I think there's a lot of talent around the world. Not all the talent comes from Silicon Valley. There's also talent in other countries, but they need to be unlocked. And as soon as you bring them into this community, you see them excel because they get people around them that are like-minded, that also are helping them. And this idea that you unlock the talent of the world for the solutions that we need to solve challenges that we need have in the next 10 years is making me going out of my bed every day and to solve that puzzle.